Hi Scorpio, welcome to October 2018 reading. This is going to be for Scorpio, Sun, Moon and Rising. Guys, my name is Ayushi, for those of you who do not know this, and welcome to my channel, all of you. And I'm from India. I know for past couple of months I wasn't posting, and before I stopped posting 2 months ago, I think I had many people who were from this Scorpio zodiac who were waiting on for readings from me, and I'm sorry guys if I disappointed you and kept you waiting, but now I'm posting it. So let's see what's coming up for Scorpio Sun Moon Rising. This is a Scorpio card. This just came out. This is about second chances. This is about something coming back from the past, someone asking for forgiveness. This is about letting go of things that do not serve you anymore. Some of you are probably deciding not to forgive someone and leave the situation for something better, for something more peaceful, something that more something that resonates with your something that resonates with you more than the current situation. Some of you are dealing with a Virgo person, or you are going, some of you are also going on to a path of spirituality, or somewhere you just want to be left alone, I'm feeling, and you don't want to deal with thoughts and ideas, and there is something going on in your head with, and you're trying to get away from those thought patterns, and you want to seek solace by isolating yourself. Okay, so this is why it is coming up, because you recently probably went through a heartbreak or a betrayal or a breach of trust, so you are taking your time to heal from that. So I think what I'm getting here is that you can only move forward from this situation if you decide that you will forgive the person that has hurt you. And I'm not saying take that person back, but I'm saying forgive that person in order to move forward. If you really want to move forward, you will have to forgive that person. What are the messages coming in for Scorpio Sun Moon Rising for October 2018? Messages for Scorpio Sun Moon Rising for October 2018. Messages for Scorpio Sun Moon Rising. So the Fool and the Seven of Cups. So there was some confusion, or you feel that there was something hidden from your eyesight, like something was like you did not see it coming. Something was something was very foggy and unclear. You feel that you were not able to see the reality of something, and it came out of nowhere. Or there is an opportunity which is coming your way out of nowhere, and you have to decide if you want to take that up. You are still deciding, is it worth risking or taking that step, or you are just deciding that I have too many options, and that means that I need to start something, like I need to pick one of the option and start building from the scratch, and take a leap of faith and take the risk and start investing in it and start working on it. You could be dealing with a Pisces or a Cancer or a Aries person. So there is definitely a lot of unknown, unanswered questions. You don't know if you should move forward. You don't know if you should take that leap of faith. So yes, you are questioning a lot, and you are like, you might be anxious as well, and you are probably feeling that you don't have clarity of thought right now. Some of you might be waiting on for a certain information to come your way before you can make up your mind. This is for Scorpio Sun Moon Rising, October 2018. This is for Scorpio Sun Moon Rising, October 2018. What are the messages coming in for Scorpio Sun Moon Rising 2018, October? Okay, one last shuffle. Something at workplace. You are trying to decide where should I begin? Where should I start laying down the foundation? Where should I start collaborating with what kind of people? Where should I apply for job? For where should I send out my resume? This is also about, should I keep working with this person that I'm working with, or should I just start working alone? You are deciding. Are my companions or who are with me right now, are they truly investing equally as much as I am investing? Are they truly supporting my vision, my idea, my dream? Some of you are at workplace and somebody is challenging you, who is probably a fire sign, Aries. I'm also getting Virgo, Leo and Sagittarius. Somebody who is trying to someone who is probably immature and they are trying to be playful and they are trying to distract you. This person can be probably somebody just telling you that they have physical attraction towards you. Someone just showing you a lot of, like, they are showing a lot of interest towards you, and this person can be a challenge if they are showing a lot of interest towards you, if, especially if it has workplace. So either somebody can get deviated at workplace, or you are having difficulty at workplace because you are not enthusiastic. You might be feeling that you are not inspired to go to work, or yes, that's what I'm getting. Because you want to stay in, you want to not move out, see other people. You want to just be left alone, and this can be a Virgo person as well that you are dealing with. Somebody, this can also be somebody who is, like I'm saying, like looking for answers within them, their own self, and they know that there is nothing outside of themselves, and they will have to come to a conclusion all by themselves. This can also be that somebody is retreating and they are not communicating, so you are trying to understand what is happening with this person. In past, again, a major arcana. This is a temperance card. You could be dealing with a Sagittarius, some of you. It is showing me that somebody in past had a lot of passion. Now I think this is the same passion which is coming up as a challenge now, like somebody is more interested than the other person, and which is why one person is very, very emotional. And somebody is trying to balance this. Like, you might have felt that you have found your soulmate in the past, but now you are trying to take your energy back, or you are trying to retreat back because you want to understand what has happened in the past or who this person was. You are probably trying to understand if their temperament aligns with your temperament. On your mind, Mother of Swords. So you don't want to express anything, or somebody around you doesn't want to express their emotions. So you just want to be professional, cutthroat, and you want to say things as it is, as they are, and you don't want to get swayed by your emotions. You don't want to you don't want your emotions to cloud your judgment. And you can be very, very cold and harsh at this point. Or this is somebody like Libra, Aquarius, Gemini, Sun, Moon, Rising, or somebody else who is just acting very, very they're just acting like ruthless and ignorant, or they are just probably just ignoring. In future, I see that you are healing, or somebody around you is healing. This person is going through recovery. They are also having a moment of enlightenment. They are like an aha moment they are having, and this is happening because they are trying to avoid certain thoughts and ideas. Give me a moment. This person is trying to avoid other people's ideas and opinion about them, their work. this can be just you trying to think about the things that has already happened in the past. There could have been a heartbreak that you are trying to heal in the future. Somebody is very still and they are not acting at all, like they are not reacting, they are just trying to keep their balance, trying to keep their balance, trying to not be too enthusiastic. Yes. This can be in your family situation or family dynamic where a child is not very enthusiastic or they are needing a lot of attention, or you're trying to balance your work life because you're not able to give enough time to your child. Something of that nature is coming here. Like I feel that somebody's child is sick here and you want to be there for them. And I'm also getting that you want your happiness and you're working towards it. You are trying to give more like selfless service towards your family or to the relatives or something like that. I'm getting here in your surrounding nine of cups. So yes, there can be somebody in your in the dynamic in your situation who is addicted to something, and you're trying to heal this person by giving them support. This can be you as well. It can also mean that some of your desires are going to be fulfilled and you are working tirelessly towards fulfilling your, those desires. And this may not be just your desire, it can be somebody else's desires as well, and you want to fulfill those desires for them. Something of that nature is coming. But mindful, be mindful that somebody can drag you into their addiction and their fantasy land. As soon as I said fantasy, so you are afraid that something is being hidden from you. You are afraid that you will not see things clearly, and you are afraid that you are confused. You are afraid that there is some mystery that you are not able to uncover. And your outcome is the strength card. So the Leo person you could be dealing with, or a Cancer or a Pisces. I'm getting that you, by the end of this month, you are very very courageous, or you are dealing with somebody who is like a beast, or who is somebody very like somebody hard to tackle, but you are able to tackle them because of your tact and diplomacy and your sheer patience and grace. You are doing it gracefully, and I'm getting that you know that you have a lot of power within you, and that's why you are able to handle the situation. There is some obstacle by the end of the month, and you are able to you are very cool about it, and you are able to handle it because you are so calm. Here you are so calm. Here you are working on your healing. Again, very graceful. You are trying to win over someone by love, by giving them some care and attention. Here also you are very very calm. Now overall energy is the Ace of Pentacles. So yes, you are building from something from scratch, something like a seed. You have planted a seed and you are waiting for it to grow, and you are being very patient with this seed. You don't want your emotions or something unknown to disturb it. You want to be very certain how you are going to make this grow, and you don't want anything else to distract you or come in between your dreams and your work. Basically, whatever it is, it can be anything. It can be a commitment with a person, because I think in past there was some three-party situation, or it is still lingering, and you had to leave the situation with a heavy heart, like you had invested a lot of emotions, so now you don't want to get emotional about it. You are pretty much ready to give commitment, or you want a commitment and deep stability. Okay, so this is what I'm getting here. What I'm getting here is that somebody here who can be a Virgo or a Gemini, this person is trying to stay single, or this is you just trying to stay single. You are choosing not to spend your time, or you spend your love elsewhere. You just want to stay single, or probably you are deciding that like between two people, you are trying to decide which one to choose. you need clarity, you want truth, you want to speak the truth, you want to know the truth, you want to live in the truth, you don't want to live in illusions. With regards to family and wanting 10 of pentacles, you are waiting for your luck to turn, you are waiting for good times to come, you are waiting for you're being very patient with timing, like the divine timing. You are being very, very patient, and you are ready to heal yourself for a union that would be mutual, that would be which will fulfill your heart's desire. So you know that you will have to heal yourself in order to get to this. So that is what you are doing. In as an outcome, if you are dealing with a Leo, there has been a heartbreak by the end of this month, or you are trying to overcome this heartbreak by a Leo with lot of courage. And how you are doing it is by leaving the situation and the thoughts that are troubling you. And you are trying not to think about this over and over again, because you know it has been done, and it is in your past, so you want to get over with it. You want to move to something very, very peaceful now and start something very new. And you want to spend time with your friends, and you don't want to dwell into that dark zone. I'm also getting that there can be some wish fulfillment, and someone from abroad or someone from distance can come and meet you, and this can be that you will feel like either you are going to this person to meet them or they are coming to you, but it is a wish fulfillment. But what I'm also getting that if that's not the case, this person is trying to connect with you like through SMS or call, and it is making you very, very happy. But be mindful that this person is very emotional, and this person has nothing concrete. This person is only offering you some temptation. This is a Virgo card and a Daughter of Wands and the Moon card. So yes, if you are dealing with a Virgo or a fire sign or Pisces or a Cancer, you're not sure if you want to invest in this or you want to nurture this person, even though you want to nurture this person and you want to give time to your dreams and ideas, and you want to spend time and doing all those things, and you don't want to settle for anything less. And you're trying to gain clarity over the situation where you feel like you have to nurture somebody. It can be that some of you are trying to nurture your child and you're very worried about their health condition. Yes, some of you are very focused on your work. Like you are putting all your focus in your work. You are stubborn. And you have a path and you want to not budge from that path. You just want to keep going. Yes, you want to just keep going. You are very diligent. You are working behind the scene. You are working overtime. And you just want to build yourself so that you can have this family union and family foundation you can lay. And when the time is right, you want to have this 10 of pentacles. And somehow you know that things will start moving in your direction and you will have wish fulfillment. So the problem that you are having is that you feel that you don't have enough enthusiasm, because right now probably you are going through a heartbreak and it is making you upset, so you don't feel like going to work and stuff like that. But that is going to be resolved if you take up this approach where you become very tactful, and you become very patient with your own self and start taming your own mind. Like you have to not give in to your whims and desires, and if you know that you have to work to get something done, then get it done. That's your message, Scorpio, for October. I hope it resonated. In case it did, kindly drop me a comment. That will help me understand that my readings are helpful. So yeah, I'll see you again.